Hello, Adam Wilkinson, CEO of Jade Bloom, here today to talk about carrier oils. Now, in aromatherapy, I think essential oils unfairly take the spotlight. Well, carrier oils really just don't get the credit they deserve.
We got screwed.
In fact, did you know that carrier oils actually make your essential oils safer, more effective, and provide nutrients for your body? Essential oils, there's no nutrients. It's just chemicals, natural chemicals. So if you want sexy hair, smooth, glowing skin, carrier oil should be part of your natural daily regimen. Do I have your attention?
You've got my attention, Mr.
Okay, great. For me, the easiest way to understand a carrier oil was to compare how they differ from essential oils in composition, production, and utility. In other words, what are these things made of? How are they made? How are they used? Carrier oils can also be referred to as a vegetable oil, a fixed oil, or a base oil. While the composition of an essential oil is 100% chemicals, the composition of a carrier oil actually contains nutrients which include vitamins, minerals, and fatty acids. The differing composition of a carrier oil is a result of both how the oil is processed as well as the part of the plant that it is derived. While essential oils are typically processed using a method called steam distillation, the highest quality carrier oils use a different process called cold pressing. The process actually presses the fatty portions of the botanical without adding heat. Now, while the process itself can generate heat from friction, the heat is kept to a minimum so as to not harm the nutrients. While essential oils are distilled from the flowers, leaves, bark, and roots of a botanical, carrier oils are cold pressed from the seeds, nuts, and kernels. Over time, essential oils are susceptible to oxidation, while carrier oils are susceptible to going rancid. Rancidity occurs when the fat molecules in oils break down. So since 100% pure essential oils do not contain fat molecules, they cannot go rancid. Carrier oils can. Although it's not likely that you will get sick from rancid carrier oil like you would eating meat that has gone bad, rancid oils can lose nutrients and have an unpleasant odor and taste. Okay, now that we have a better understanding of how carrier oils are made and what they are made of, let's dive into the part I know you've been waiting for, and that's how do we use these things. Now I have here some carrier oils that Jade Bloom sells. We currently have about 50 different options sold in 2 ounce or 4 ounce glass bottles. These are some of the most popular. We have Rosehip, Fractionated Coconut Oil, Black Seed, my personal favorite, Grape Seed, Almond, and Papaya. Now we don't have time in this video to do a deep dive into each one of these oils, but stay tuned because each of these deserves its own video. The most popular use of carrier oils is to dilute the potency of your essential oils. You need to be sure to consult a safe uses guide. Jade Bloom has published a free version that you can access from any web browser simply by going to app.jadebloom.com. Or for 99 cents, you can download a native app version that we published to both the iOS and Android app stores simply by searching the official oil guide. As a general rule of thumb, you can follow a safe dilution ratio of 2%, which is about 12 drops of essential oil mixed into 1 fluid ounce of carrier oil. Let's see what that looks like. So I have here a 2 ounce shot glass, because I always take my shots in at least 2 ounces. Let's pour in some carrier. So we talked about 12 drops into 1 ounce of carrier oil would look about like that. Now this is black cumin seed, my favorite carrier oil, because of the amount of compounds and nutrients it contains. It's been dubbed the healthiest oil in the world, and I actually consume about a tablespoon a day to keep the sickness away. That was lame. Cheers. Now, if you are taking any medications, I actually don't recommend you consume any oils without talking to your doctor first. Now, I do want to create a dedicated video for each of the carrier oils I've already introduced to you, but to help you have a better appreciation for the versatility and the uses of carrier oils in general, allow me to make a personal introduction to each of my friends. You've already met black cumin seed, which is part of my nutritional daily regimen. Black seed is loaded with essential amino acids, omega-3 fatty acids, and vitamin A. It also contains a major active compound called thymoquinone, which scientific evidence suggests activates our immune system and can provide a myriad of health benefits. Even though black seeds have been used for over 2,000 years, most of the scientific research we have is fairly new, and I'm actually very excited to see what we continue to discover about this wonderful oil. Next, we have rosehip seed oil, which is known as the queen of skin oils. In addition to helping hydrate your skin, rosehip contains linoleic and linolenic acids, which help strengthen the cellular walls of your skin cells. There are many great carrier oils that provide amazing benefits for your skin, but rosehip is a must-have for your collection. Fractionated coconut oil is a customer favorite because it is tasteless, odorless, and unlike traditional coconut oil that hardens at temperatures below 76 degrees, fractionated coconut oil does not contain lauric acid that is responsible for the hardening property. This stuff will stay liquid in your refrigerator. Now, grape seed was the very first carrier oil offered by Jade Bloom, and it is very high in polyunsaturated fats, mainly omega-6s, as well as vitamin E. Now, while this is a great oil for your skin and hair, I actually don't recommend consuming grape seed since most American diets are already getting an excess of omega-6s relative to the omega-3 fatty acids that they should be getting. Next, we have almond oil, which is a great source for magnesium, phosphorus, and copper. It is antioxidant rich, and it's known for its free radical fighting capabilities. Jade Bloom's almond oil is great for cooking, cleansing hair follicles, or even improving your skin tone. Lastly, and probably the least known of the carrier oils that I introduced to you today, is papaya seed oil. Because of its non-greasy and light texture, we've seen this oil rise in popularity for use in the oil cleansing method. It's a great natural exfoliant with powerful compounds that can help lighten scars. Papaya seed has some great anti-inflammatory properties to it that have proven to work well with inflamed skin conditions such as eczema or psoriasis. Okay, that about does it for what I had planned to cover today on the awesome world of carrier oils. You know, I really hope that this information is helpful in your natural health journey. I know the information sometimes can be overwhelming and stepping into something new, but your body and your mind will thank you. Please continue your education. And today, I thank you for trusting me with your time and our exploration of oils. Until next time.